Welcome to the American Dream. We have a fun segment coming up right now. First, I'm going to introduce you to Robert Ott. He is managing broker of Compass Real Estate, and he has brought with him John Bowler. He is co-founder and chief strategist of Grid Consulting. So excited to talk to you both. I want to get started and jump right in. I know you've got some great things to talk about.
I thought today that we could sit down and talk about problems that first-time buyers are having in this market. And I thought a great person to talk to is my good friend, John. John was a first-time buyer. He bought, how long ago did you buy?
It was in December of 2016.
Okay. And when John bought his first home, he had a lot of questions and found out a lot of the things about buying a home kind of after the fact. And I thought, well, what a great segment to have about what it's like to be a first-time buyer and what we might be able to do to help people feel good about their buying their home for the very first time.
Sure. Yeah. So I guess, you know, thanks for having me first off.
Yeah.
You know, the first thing that really stood out is kind of the change and the shift that's happening with real estate professionals and myself as a first time home buyer and having never experienced it. I found myself asking, you know, a lot of questions.
Yeah.
The questions were specifically in regards to my finances and whether I should get, if I should put 20% down. And then what are all the kind of benefits of buying versus renting and how that impact my future?
Yeah. Yeah. So did anyone ever discuss that with you before you bought your home? And that wasn't me, by the way. If you was somebody else. Really hurt my feelings, but that's all right. So so what happened? Did you just figure things out on your own, or did you hear about them afterwards? How did that all go about?
Yeah, so I met with a real estate agent, I met with a couple actually, and started asking questions. And, you know, I found a lot from my real estate professional that I was partnered with, but then also my mortgage professional.
Mm-hmm.
I'd say the thing that I was, like, overly surprised with was this concept of if you live in the home for 2 years out of five, then you could have, like, a crazy tax break. Could you explain that?
Yeah. Well, I'm certainly not a tax accountant, and so I'm going to give you the very small kind of the skinny version of it. Yeah, there's some great tax advantages to owning a home. Not only do you get a break because you get to write off your interest in the taxes that you pay on your payments, but also when you go to sell it, as long as it's been your primary home for the last 5 years, then the money that you get is kind of free. As long as it doesn't go over $250,000 for a single person or $500,000 if you're a couple. So that's it. It's like free money. It's money that you don't really even report. It's just at the end of the day, you just put it into your account, move it to the next house, or go buy a car, whatever you want to do.
That was really wild to me because the interest is the thing that you always hear about. But hearing that if your home appreciates $250,000 and I could actually get that tax free, like that was something I think should be talked about in every conversation for millennials and first-time homebuyers.
Yeah, well, that's one of the reasons I thought this conversation would be so great. So that way people who are wondering if they should buy a home or not, they get to know the things before they buy instead of after they buy. So I think these little tidbits can help people make a better decision for their life. Now, what is something else that you remember, like, afterwards, you learned after you bought a home?
Sure. So, and again, I think, like, the role of the real estate professional, you're becoming this kind of wealth manager and teaching people how do you make money from your home? How do you create wealth from your home? I guess the two that really stand out is the should I put 20% down or should I put 5% down? And then a lot of my peers talk about the concept of HOA. Is that worth it or not worth it?
Yeah.
I'd love to hear kind of how you approach that with first-time home buyers.
Yeah, as far as wealth management goes, I think for anybody who's looking to buy a home, they should be asking the real estate agent, hey, so what do you think? What is your opinion on buying this house? Is this a good investment, a bad investment? Is this a good location, bad location? But also, should I be putting a lot of money down or should I be putting a little bit of money down? And everyone thinks, hey, just put down a lot of money. It's easier. But there could be ways you can make money off of the money you're going to put as a down payment. There's other ways to make money off that. So it's not always just about getting the lowest payment. Sometimes it's about getting the highest return.
Sure.
Right? So it'd be good for your real estate agent to talk to you about that beforehand. A lot of people think you have to have 20% down. Let's see, there's 3.5% down programs, 3% down programs, 0% down programs that I think anyone could take advantage of in as long as you fit the right criteria.
So there's an insurance, if you don't put 20% down, there's an insurance that you ultimately are responsible for.
Yeah. Yeah, there's what we call mortgage insurance. And I think maybe that's a big, broad category that maybe we should have a lender on to talk about that someday. Because that's just, it all depends on your loan program and how much you put down and everything else.
Sure.
Yeah.
That was a great That was a great conversation, and I am so glad that you guys really brought this up. And I loved hearing from both of you as a home buyer, as a professional, and interacting so that our viewers can really see what is so important and what home buyers are thinking and feeling. We sometimes don't always stop to remember that, and it was really a great representation. I appreciate you both so much. Thank you.
Oh, awesome. Thank you so much. Really appreciate your time. Thanks for having us on.
Yeah, thank you so much.